As if I need another reason to binge watch her videos. Like, this is literally my I woke up like this look. And to Kate, I want to say thank you. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm taking a break from my normal tech writing videos and trying something new. One of my favorite YouTubers, Kate Kavanaugh, has this amazing series of writing experiments where she tries writing like a famous author for one day. I am obsessed with this series. And Kate recently crossed the 10,000 subscriber mark. And to congratulate her, I thought it would be fun to write like Kate for one day. So that's what I'm doing today. Now, Kate writes fiction. So her writing process is more geared towards novel writing. So I'm going to try using her novel writing process for my technical writing work. We'll see how that goes. Now, I was thinking about how do I figure out her writing process. And I found that Kate made a very helpful video about her ideal writing day. And at the end of that video, she has a breakdown of what her ideal working day would look like.
So what I came up with is 2 hours of freelance, 1 hour of AuthorTube, 2 hours of revision work, and 1 hour of zero draft work.
So along with writing novels, Kate is also a freelance writer, so she has to work on her freelance assignments. So that's what she means by 2 hours of freelance. I don't have any freelance work, but I am working on a personal blog post, so I think that's what I'm going to do in those 2 hours. Then 1 hour of AuthorTube, and I think I'm going to just work on this video for 1 hour for my YouTube stuff. Then she has 2 hours of revision work and 1 hour of zero draft work. So zero drafting is her process of getting the story out of her brain and onto the screen. So that's kind of what I called the throwaway draft, like just a brain dump of everything that I have been thinking of a particular subject so that I can get it out of my head onto the screen and then make sense of it. So 2 hours of revision work and 1 hour of zero draft work is what I'll do for my book assignments. In her ideal writing day video, she also talks about her ideal schedule.
I would get up at 5:30 like usual and work out and be ready to work starting at 8:30. I learned that from my experiment. And then I've managed to fit it all in and then be done theoretically with work by 4, and also included an hour and a half.
She has workout in the morning, which I'm going to skip. We are going to follow her writing process, which starts at 8:30 in the morning. So that's what we are going to do. So it's 8:30 to 9:30 of zero draft work, 9:30 to 10:30 of freelance, 10:30 to 11:30 of AuthorTube, 11:30 to 1 a midday walk, 1 to 2 freelance, and 2 to 4 revision work. So that's my schedule for the day. Okay, so let's start the day of writing like Kate Kavanaugh. Okay, so it is 8:30 a.m. and I have my coffee, my water, my notes, and my laptop. So we are good to go. Okay, so the way my tech writing process works is that I first try out the procedure that I want to document. And while trying it out, I make a note of every step that I take. Because like if I mess something up, I need to know what I messed up. And for that, I need to know what I did. So I like meticulously note down every step that I take when I'm trying out a new procedure. And then I reverse engineer it and then come up with an outline for the document. Like these are the steps that need to be taken to build an app with CockroachDB and Kubernetes. And then I again go back to my laptop and I'll start the actual drafting process in Markdown. Let's do that. Okay, so it is 9:31 a.m. and I did quite a bit of zero drafting. It's still not done, but I think it's a good start. Normally, I would have kept going because I'm in a good flow. So I think if I wasn't doing this writing experiment, I would have just kept working on this document. But we are trying out Kate's process today, and Kate likes to switch projects, and I want to see if I benefit from switching projects as well. So I'm going to stop writing this document now, and instead I'm going to switch over to this document, which is a personal blog post slash writing guidelines for my team. And I've been working on this document since ages, so I'm very glad that I'm finally getting the time to sit down and focus on this. So that's what we are going to do for the next hour. And also, I'm going to play some music because it is very quiet in here. Writing playlist. Harry Potter. I love writing to Harry Potter music. Okay, so it is 10:31 a.m. and I did quite a bit of rough drafting. So I've been writing for 2 hours straight, so my brain is a bit fried right now. And I think that is because I switched projects and the context switching kind of was a bit jarring. But I did get a lot of work done for the work assignment and also for this blog post slash article thing that I'm working on. So it was a very productive morning. It's just that the context switching took a bit more energy than I realized it would. But what's the next thing is 1 hour of YouTube. So I think I'm just going to edit this video. So I record on my phone and the phone syncs to Google Cloud, and so I need to download the videos from Google down onto my laptop and then edit in iMovie. So I'm going to start down the download process now, and while it's downloading, I'm going to get some coffee. Okay, so it's 10:59 a.m. and the videos have downloaded. I've copied them over to iMovie and now I'm going to start editing them. I also want to edit the video like Kate does. Like, she has this little pre-cap at the beginning of the video where she has like snippets from the video in the beginning, and then she has this blooper reel at the end on the end screen. So I think that will be fun. And so I probably should go and look at some more of her videos to see how she edits them. Like, as if I need another reason to binge watch her videos. But yeah, that will be fun. So I'm going to do that now. So I edited all the recording that I made since morning, and I realized how sleepy I look. Like, this is literally my, I woke up like this look. So I think I'm going to take a break. Like, according to Kate, this is supposed to be my break time. I went over time with the editing. It is noon right now and it is supposed to be my midday walk, but it's super hot outside and I don't want to go out. But I'm going to take a break. I'm going to go freshen up a bit and get some lunch, and then I'll see you in 1 hour. I took a longer break than I expected. I took a break till 2 p.m. Kate's break ends at 1 p.m. so I'm running a bit late. But I did start working at 2 p.m. and I worked on the UX writing blog post a bit more. So I worked on that till 3 p.m. and then I'm supposed to do revision work for 2 more hours. But I really don't feel like working on. So instead, I'm going to read a book. I'm beta reading a book for one of the programmers. And it's an interesting book. I've read a bit of it yesterday and he wants to publish the book in July. So I want to provide him feedback in the next couple of weeks so he has time to process the feedback and make changes if required. And the weather is really nice right now. Like, it's windy and breezy and there's shade. So I thought I'll just hang out on the rooftop for a bit. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to sit here, read the book, and then I'll update you in a while. Okay, so it's 5:02 p.m. which marks the end of my writing experiment of writing like Kate Kavanaugh, and I had a lot of fun and I was also very productive, and I'm very happy about that. And to Kate, if you're watching, I want to say thank you. Thank you for creating such an amazing, uplifting online community. Being a tech writer, I kind of have two identities. Like, I belong to two communities. The one is tech, where it's pretty easy to be a part of. But the writing community somehow, especially the real life writing communities, are not as welcoming. And I always felt like an outsider or an imposter and always insecure about my writing, until I found your channel and the other author tubers channels. And then I finally found a place where I could participate and not be as insecure. So thank you so much for creating such a positive, welcoming space, and for your honest chats and your fun vlogs. Just thank you for everything. And to my regular viewers, I hope this was fun. I'll get back to my regular programming next week. Next week, I want to discuss the UX writing and microcopy article that I was working on and everything I learned in the process. I'll see you then. Until then, happy writing. It's at 1 p.m. So I'm... Okay. Bye, babe. Oh, there are two planes in the sky. Nice.